when I pull up to the club, sitting tall in my
Haitian
car.
Fresh.
Don't hate, but it just
Gucci.
Hey, what's good, y'all, man? It's your boy Lucky Adventure holding it down with IVTV, man. You know what I'm saying? I got my man's LooseKannon right here with the main guest. You already know, man, my boy Haitian Fresh, man. What it do, boy?
You lie, bro. Hey, we out here.
You already know what it is, my yeah, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Bro. So before we get all into the meat and potatoes, Fresh, you know what I'm saying? Let them know where you from, what you represent, you know what I'm saying? Your camp.
Haiti, bro. Haiti, what a prince. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm from, bro. Palm Beach County, Miami. You know what I'm saying? We just been doing it, man. We just try to beat the odds every day. But that's all I've been doing, bro. I've been like ever since day one in the game, bro. I felt like I always had to prove myself. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, you know how niggas is when you start rapping. You know, niggas like, man, that nigga got money. He ain't no, you know, like you get all the hate.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so me, it's like the more hate I get, the better I do.
That drive.
So yeah, so they did that to the wrong nigga. You know what I'm saying? So he's been, you know, when I came in the game head first, bro, I ain't no shit about rap. I just love music.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So I had a plan though, because whatever I do, I never fell at it. So I knew it's gonna take time, but at the same time, I knew if they give me a chance, it's gonna be over with.
Exactly.
And that's basically what's happening before and just like round two.
That's real talk. Just let y'all know that's out here viewing this shit, man. It's always good to have a plan, man. Without a plan, you ain't shit, man. Make sure you stay focused, have your goal, have you something to chase, you know what I mean? You ain't shit without a plan, just know that. So, alright, we were just talking about it before we started the interview, man, how you came about, that gon' jump, you know what I'm saying? You snap with the shit, Wyclef, Boosie, you know what I'm saying? How the hell did that even come about for you to even do that?
Nah, I had like three niggas I knew that rap, bro. I used to want them niggas to be successful.
Mm-hmm.
So one day I was like, man, I'm a, you know, pay for y'all studio, man, because I believe in y'all.
Yeah.
So I used to go to the studio every fucking night, and it's taking them niggas like 10 hours to do a verse. So I'm like, my pocket getting weak. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, nigga need a pound of weed, nigga need this. I'm like, bro, nigga going broke. So one night I just went behind that booth, bro, and I started talking. Then the engineer was like, man, I fuck with your voice. He didn't say I fuck with your rap. He said, I fuck with your voice. You need to do it because you got that voice.
Rap.
And I was like, damn, maybe I need to spend this money on me. You know what I'm saying? So I remember I said, I'm going to rap. I'm going to do that shit. But I wanted to do it just so I could stay off the streets. You know what I'm saying? Because that's the best way to, because all my niggas was dying, going to jail. So I'm like, man, let me just, because everybody rap. You know what I'm saying? But I wanted to do something that's going to leave a legacy behind. I wanted to just, when I first did it, the first 6 months, I was trying to rap. You know what I'm saying? But I was like, this ain't for me, bro. I almost gave up on it because I ain't one of them niggas that's going to be writing shit and try to just hit bars and bars.
Nice.
So I was like, shit, man, I need to just, and niggas used to be like, what name you gonna have? So I called myself Fresh for the first 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
Then I said, nah, man, I'm gonna be just like every nigga that rap. So I said, I'm gonna take a name that nobody respect. Cause at that time, niggas weren't respecting Haitians.
Yeah.
So every nigga was like, man, that nigga Haitian, they used to hate us. So I said, you know what, not only I'm gonna rap, cause I can't rap, but I'm gonna call myself Haitian Fresh.
Damn,
so bro. Everything's against me, bro.
Stamp,
you know what
shit.
I'm saying? Then what I did, I took like 30 grand, bro, and I got on every cover. Every cover, because back then we had Hood Magazine,
yeah.
Ozone. So I just paid every nigga. I paid every nigga to be on every cover, because I said, you know what, I'm finna do this shit the back way.
Four speed.
Nah, I'm finna make sure they know me.
Yeah, exactly.
Bitch,
yeah.
You don't know no song, but you gonna know me.
Yeah, yeah.
So I did that shit, so I noticed, like, everywhere I go, motherfuckers like, let's take a picture, let's do this. But everybody like, but what the fuck do you do?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, oh, man, I don't got no choice but to drop a song now. So that's when I was in Orlando. And nigga know me and they know Boosie. And they was like, bro, Boosie here, Boosie say he fuck with you. So I was like, I fuck with him. So we met at the studio.
Yeah.
And one of my niggas sent me a song called Gone Job. You know what I'm saying? And they played that shit and Boosie jumped on it. I did my verse and that was it from there, bro. That was a classic. Then the second single came right after that, Season of the Zoe. You know what I'm saying? My brother BSU, my Haitians, you know what I'm saying? They sent me that song because they knew that I rap the Zoe, cause that's when I knew that was my space in hip hop.
Mm-hmm.
When a nigga see me, they gonna see that flag. They gonna be like, that nigga rap the Zoe. Cause you gotta stand for something when you rap, bro. Everybody can't. Everybody rap, but not everybody make money rapping.
Yeah.
You feel me? So I wanted to take this shit. If they ain't gonna like the music, they gonna respect what the fuck I'm doing. And that's what it is. Yeah.
Right. That's what it is. So, all right. don't rap, fuck it. You in the game, you know what I'm saying? The push is real. How does it feel to actually be somebody that wasn't rapping? You know what I'm saying? Actually had a faith in yourself to even, you know what I mean? Bro, how the fuck does that feel,
bro? It feel good, bro, but I know I got a long way to go.
Exactly.
Cause my goal is to be the nigga in the rap. I don't just want to be a rapper. I want to be that nigga, like how Jay-Z buy
shooting for something.
No, yeah, like how he buying teams and shit. That's what I want to do. I don't want to just rap. I want to leave a legacy behind it. That's where we head towards. Because there ain't no country or state we could go where a bitch don't know Haitian Fresh, because I did the legwork. You feel me? So now it's like okay, what we going to do next year? You know what I'm saying? Because every year I try to have a plan where I'm going to do, okay, I did 106 in part this year. Next year I want to do the red carpet at the BET Awards. And I remember the first time, bro, a nigga sitting there next to Beyonce, bro, and Jay-Z front row, and you know, and LL Cool J, Jadakiss on fifth row. And I was like, damn, nigga, we here. You feel me? Just feel good, because those are shit you dream about.
Exactly.
So when you actually there, bro, with these people, like,
around that
when somebody like LooseKannon, we go to BET Awards, you know what I'm saying? He gonna feel, you know what? Because some niggas, you give him a little taste of that, bro, you did the wrong thing, because that's where they want to be. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They and not everybody get that chance, bro, because we probably never met the best rapper alive, to be honest with you.
Yeah, of course.
Because they never got a chance.
Because
in the game, bro, it's all about having money or having connection or kiss ass. See, me, I probably could have been a lot further if I kiss ass, but I never kiss ass. It was like, nigga, you fuck with me, you fuck with me. I'm not going, I don't do no fake that. No fake, like, nigga, because that's all they did to me. Every time a nigga see me, and they know who they are, you know what I'm saying? A bunch of big niggas, and I don't owe nothing against them, because that's how they move.
Yeah.
Fresh, man, you're my brother, I love you, but I'm like, damn, this nigga never, I do a song with this nigga, I gotta chase him for the video.
Blah, blah, blah.
I gotta, you feel me? But at the end of the day, I stayed humble, because nobody owe you shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because if your brand, if you work hard and you put the work down, bro, niggas gonna come to you, you don't gotta go to them.
Yeah.
When you call them, they gonna pick up first call. You feel me?
Exactly.
So I was like, you know what? I need to work a little harder. I never blame them. And that's how I do it.
Damn right. That goes to show once again, man. Put in the legwork. You believe in the legwork that you put in. You will get out of what you put into it. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? You're looking at it as living proof right now. You know what I'm saying? So, and no more fake daps, though. I want to say something about that shit. That's that trouble.
Yeah, trouble. Trouble.
Okay, bet. You know what I'm saying? That shit was sliding, though. You know what I mean? I'm going to give you some props on that one. I like that motherfucker. I used to listen to that bitch all the time. Just to keep it 100 with you. You know what I'm saying?
I think Walker jumped on the remix.
Yeah, actually he did, but that wasn't how the original one went, though, from what I...
Okay. Nah, because I never pushed the first one.
Exactly.
But the second one, I did YouTube shit, bro.
Yeah.
That's it, nigga ain't, like, I ain't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying?
It was just,
let's do it and do... See, now I know the business side of the game, so I'm not going to fuck up again.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because I know you got to do the BMI, I got all the right people around me. You know what I'm saying? Because on my team, none of us knew shit about that. I used to just do shows, meet them there at the gas station, get 6 stacks, nigga, I'll be at your shit. I did that. We did that about 100 times. You feel me? And the money they give me, I throw that shit out at their club. Because it wasn't about the money. It was just me trying to just show this nigga love. You know what I'm saying? So now it's like it's different, bro. Everything got to be business, professional, have the right people around you. And that's it. That's where, you know, with Sanzave, my new single. That shit took off by itself. I ain't never experienced nothing like that, bro.
Let's get into that. So, yeah. How the hell, like, what made you, what does that stand for? What does that mean?
Bro, Sanzave is like, it's like a, like it's 15 different definitions. But to me,
what's your definition?
My definition is like a nigga that's like, he ain't shit. You know what I'm saying? He's a forgotten nigga. He the nigga, the underdog. He the nigga that when a nigga see him, it's like he ain't gonna do shit with his life. He never gonna be nothing.
Yeah.
Savage. You know what I'm saying? He a thug. That's what it is. But how that came was just two of my niggas. You know what I'm saying? That I knew from Season of the Zoes when I first started. So them niggas came up with the song. You know what I'm saying? From Miami, they Sons of Bay boys. You know they got that shit and they was like, man, everybody was trying to get the song. Jason, a lot of niggas that's big up there, but they ain't have my street. You know what I'm saying? They knew if they gave them niggas a song, they ain't gonna appreciate it like I would.
Exactly.
So them niggas, you know, they thought about it. They was like, man, but fuck the money, bro. We just gonna go fresh, and that's why I love them niggas. They basically woke me out the dead, bro. They gave me that juice again. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't like hip hop, bro. Because it's fake to me, bro. I've been there with niggas that I respect, bro. That they not living. Like, they not like that. Exactly. It's like, it's a world of fakeness, bro. And I feel like that's why I didn't get in, because I'm different than them. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about, like, a bunch of big-time people I met, bro. You know what I'm saying? They was like, do this, we'll do that. And I'm like, nah, dog. I got to go back to Florida. I can't do that shit. I ain't wearing no skirt. You feel me?
Yeah.
I ain't doing no guitar. I ain't finna. So the nigga was like, damn, you got to. One nigga even told me, you got to stop repping the flag so much. I was like, bro, I'll never be rich if I got to do that. That's how I met you. You know what I'm saying? So I had to stand my ground, bro. With
stay
all that.
True to
so
yourself.
Stay
that's
true to myself. But them niggas called me, bro, and they told me, dog, they had faith in me, and I knew I couldn't drop the ball with this one, bro. So I took it a little serious, mm-hmm. And I said, this time around, we're gonna give them another anthem, and that's what it is. This shit got like 5 million views on SoundCloud.
Damn right, congrats.
It's the song that's out right now, bro. A nigga can't act like you don't see you ain't heard Sanzave.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So that's all. Yeah.
That's real. So, you got the Migos tonight?
Yeah, the Migos got a show tonight. I'm just doing my thing before them.
Exactly.
I fuck with them. Yeah.
That's what's salute to the Migos. All right, so you right here with LooseKannon. So, I don't even got to ask you about the artist you fucking with. You got one right here. You know what I'm saying? So, how that come about for y'all to even have this chemistry going on with the fuck we going to do this shit? You know what I'm saying?
Bro, my boy Snoop, bro, he a CEO nigga, bro. He helped. He got this shit on lock with the promotion game. So I looked at everybody in Orlando, you know what I'm saying, to who I'm gonna work with. So everybody vouched for that nigga. So I hit him up. We was on the phone for like 10 hours, bro. Like, I'm like, we call each other every hour. I talked to him more than I talked to niggas in 10 years. So I was like, bro, this nigga for real. So everybody told me that's that nigga. So I was fucking with him, I met him. You know what I'm saying? He just started talking about LooseKannon. Like for like 30 minutes, I'm thinking he gonna stop. But he didn't stop. He just kept talking about it. Then he played the music.
Yeah.
I was like, man, I ain't heard no music like that in a while, because I like listening to music that actually talk to me, bro, like that I could relate to. I don't just listen to music because everybody like it. It's got to fuck with me.
Exactly.
So when I heard this nigga, man, I was like, bro, I got to meet him. So I told Snoop to call him, you know what I'm saying? Then, you know, nigga vibe, you know what I'm saying? So I wanted to meet him, and we met. And my goal is to just do whatever I can, because he got everything, bro. He don't need nobody. He a boss. He been doing this shit. He gonna blow regardless whether Fresh fuck with him or not. See, me, I like niggas like that, because I know their stories be real. They 100. People love them in the streets. And that's who I want to, if I have anything to do with it, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be to just mentor and just beat up, and let's take it to the next, my connections, whatever we gotta do.
Exactly.
Cause we him, it ain't gonna be hard, cause a nigga talent, bro. I mean, the music gonna speak, and that's what people, if your music speak, yeah. And the street cred back it up, cause it's a lot of niggas, the music spoke, but the street cred didn't back it up. He got both, you know what I'm saying? So it's about communication, bro, and dealing. If I can't vibe with you, bro, I don't care if you got $30 million, bro, I'm not gonna be around you.
Most definitely.
You know what I'm saying? So with him, He could tell y'all better than I can, bro, but that nigga's already solid. We just gonna take it to the next level, bro. I'm gonna do whatever I can,
right.
And we gonna do it as a team, you feel me? Cause it's a whole team, everybody bosses, bro. Mm-hmm. From Snoop, him, you know what I'm saying? He told me, I don't even call nigga cameraman, that's a boss. So everybody bosses around this bitch, bro. We gonna do it together.
One hand watch the other, both watch the face.
That's it. Get everything accomplished.
You know what I'm saying? Unity. Without unity, you really ain't got too much. Everybody needs somebody to do something. You know what I'm saying?
Loyalty, respect is everything to me, bro.
Damn right. That's always
on the dollar. I die by that.
Damn right. So, you know what I'm saying? You really been going ham, though, bro. Like, on some real shit. You only, like you say, this wasn't really your calling or however you want to put it, but you made the most of it.
Straight God.
You really exercise every which way that you possibly can. You still got avenues that you still can touch on.
A lot.
But for it to be like this where it's at right now, you know, I got to commend you, you know what I'm saying?
Because, I appreciate it.
You know what I'm saying? It ain't too many niggas that's just going to really just keep rocking with something that's really not theirs. You know what I'm saying? Not saying it's not yours, but this ain't really your place. You want to see somebody do this shit. You know what I'm saying?
The point is this, bro. Niggas gotta understand, anybody could be a gangster, bro. But a gangster to me is a nigga that take care of their family, bro. That got God and make money.
Real
you
rapper.
See what I'm saying? Like I could sit here on this interview, bro, and try to say how many niggas I kill, my niggas kill. But at the end of the day, bro, it's a million niggas like that. You know what I'm saying? But my thing is this, bro. I want people to know, bro, it's bigger than rap, bro.
Always.
Cause 20 years from now, bro, it ain't gonna be about music. So I still want to be able to call LooseKannon and say, nigga, what's up, nigga? We about to have some barbecue today. We gonna chill, because that's when you know the respect was always there. Because you got a lot of niggas that's going to be around you because what you could do for them. They're loyal to your success and what you could do for them. I've been around a lot of niggas who was loyal to what I could do for them and my success. Not, you know what I'm saying?
Like, not unconditional.
Yeah, because that's how they are. You feel me? But at the end of the day, bro, you just keep it moving and pray for them. You don't hate them. You don't take it to the
never
streets.
Do that. Never
you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, a nigga could just watch what you do, bro. They could see, okay, damn, I wish I could. I want them to say, I wish I ain't never did that nigga wrong. Because they're going to see I stayed solid.
Eat that shit.
Success kill everything, bro.
You damn right. So before we wrap this shit up, you know what I'm saying? I just want you to give a couple words to those with the struggle. Let them know, you know what I'm saying, what it takes or what you did for you to get here, like being humble, you know what I'm saying, staying down. You know, so just let them know, you know what I mean, what it takes to actually do this without the money. You gotta
have the right team, man. You gotta believe in yourself. That's the bottom line. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta work hard. Because if you love what you do, people gonna see it. If you look at yourself as a platinum nigga, people gonna see it. You know what I'm saying? People see right through you, bro. So anybody out there, bro, you want to rap, make sure you want to do that shit for real, man. And have a backup plan, dog. You know what I'm saying? Because the average rapper get 2-3 years. So you want to have something after that. You know what I'm saying? That's my advice, bro. And do it because you love it. You know what I'm saying? Have a strong team behind you and you good. You know what I'm saying? What you want to tell them real quick, brother, before we go?
Shit, man. Y'all just stay tuned, man. You feel me? Nigga finna get in the game and fuck that shit up. That's about it.
Let them know how to reach you and then you let them know as well. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man. Look me up on IG, LooseKannon Takeoff. YouTube, LooseKannon Takeoff. Facebook, LooseKannon Takeoff. You know what I'm saying? LooseKannon everything, man.
It's Haitian Fresh, man. It's your life, bro. Your life all day. Sanzave. Sanzave worldwide. That's the new wave, man. Haitian Fresh. I ain't hard to find. Y'all know what to do, man. Y'all know what it is. New life, man. I'm Budo.
Y'all already know how to reach us, man. You know what it is. At IVTV on Instagram, man. At DaVinci400 on Instagram, man. Orlando InnerVision on Facebook, man. Y'all already know what it is, man. You know, we signing off, man, on behalf of InnerVision. You know what I'm saying? Everybody else, you know what I'm saying? We wish you the best. You already know what it is, Fresh, man.
Appreciate y'all,
all or nothing. If you stand for nothing, you'll fall for anything, man. Hold it down, man. IVTV gone.
We got you.